of 2019, 770 million people do not have access to electricity and are dependent on wood and other forms of biomass for lighting, cooking, and heating. This basic and inefficient source of energy, combined with simple ovens and poor ventilation, sets a time limit on how long people can read, study, or work indoors when there is insufficient natural light. Air pollution resulting from traditional ovens and kerosene lamps is responsible for 2.5 million premature deaths annually, especially amongst young girls and women. Not having access to a basic electricity supply also means not having access to many essential aspects of education, health, and economic safety. Having the opportunity and access to use electronic digital devices and technologies provides people with important information, such as weather, health, or safety-related news. Shazia Khan from Eco Energy points out the specific risk for countries like Pakistan, which is expected to increase its carbon emissions by 300% over the next 15 years.
The reason why this is so important is because in a country like Pakistan, where there's 210 million people, 75% of the population has unreliable access to energy. These people are having load shedding up to 18 hours a day. How can you run a business? How can your family, how can your kids study? How can you cook? How can you keep your phone charged? How can you watch the news? How can you do anything if you can't rely on power? Any of us freak out if our phones aren't charged for a few minutes, right? Or like if we're in danger, or if we don't have power for a couple of hours or for a couple of days. Imagine every day living with this uncertainty. And this is not only low-income rural villagers. This is anyone, an urban professional in Pakistan, a factory owner. Every time the power goes out, they have to reset all of their machines again. There's so many productivity losses. There's so many inefficiencies created by not having access to power.
Additionally, without access to electricity or other clean cooking options, it is unavoidable to cook with wood or other forms of biomass. More than 2.6 billion people do not have access to clean cooking options and are therefore subject to harmful air pollution from the use of emission-intensive fuels. According to the IEA, access to clean cooking facilities means access to and primary use of modern fuels and technologies, including natural gas, liquefied petroleum gas, electricity and biogas, or improved biomass cook stoves that have considerably lower emissions and higher efficiencies than traditional three-stone fires for cooking. Access to energy is at the core of United Nations Sustainable Development Goal 7. It aims to ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable, and modern energy for all. The elements most essential to a common definition of energy access include household access to a minimum level of electricity, household access to safer and more sustainable cooking and heating fuels and stoves, access to modern energy that enables productive economic activity, such as mechanical power for agriculture, textile, and other industries, and access to modern energy for public services, such as electricity for health facilities, schools, and street lighting. The IEA defines energy access as a household having reliable and affordable access to both clean cooking facilities and to electricity, which is enough to supply a basic bundle of energy services initially, and then an increasing level of electricity over time to reach the regional average. Many innovative startups and organizations are tackling these issues and are aiming to reach the Sustainable Development Goal 7. There are also a lot of innovations in this field, including decentralized solutions, which are particularly suitable for remote rural areas. Costs for solar photovoltaics in autonomous systems and mini-grids are decreasing and on track to provide affordable access to electricity for millions of people. If policymakers set their focus on decentralized solutions, it could be possible by 2030 to provide electricity to half of the people without electricity access today. startups like Eco Energy are working to improve affordable, cutting-edge solar technology and provide it directly to people with no access to electricity.
It's critically important that we get them onto a clean energy technology now. Right now, they don't have a technology, so we're not competing with anything. They barely have grid access. So if we can provide them with an alternative that's clean and that's affordable now, then that will put the entire country onto a clean energy trajectory. And that's really important because Pakistan is one of the most vulnerable countries to climate change. And so if this country can go from being a laggard energy policy and move away from coal and move on to something like solar, this can be a way for it to become a leader in fighting climate change.
Developing global access to energy is estimated to cost $35 billion per year of investment until 2030, and the impacts could be substantial.
In fact, international development experts believe that giving people access to basic infrastructure like energy over education or healthcare, for instance, is a much quicker way to enable them to break the cycle of poverty.
While it's a complex problem, the opportunities provided through the affordability and accessibility of renewable energy to improve energy access presents a massive opportunity to connect crucial resources to the world's most vulnerable.